Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be looking at the Octane IPR preview window, so it's interactive preview window. I've just got this basic scene, just it's one I've used before, and I've just wanted so I can kind of go through what all these settings are up here, the best I can anyway. So obviously reload, that stops the current render and it just makes a complete full reload of the actual scene. Pause pauses the actual IPR window. You've got redraw, which redraws the render without reloading the scene. You've got reset. I mean, reset's if your kind of scene's in the wrong position and you're trying to get it all over it, or you're trying to get it right because you've kind of zoomed in and messed about, the reset will just reset it based on the camera position and stuff. That's something I use a lot. You've got the store function. You've got clone function. The clone window, if you click wherever you're at, it'll literally clone that window, so you've got a clone version of it and so on. You've got obviously a quick save of your IPR window with some of these settings and stuff. You've got your scene focus, autofocus, or you can disable it. I don't usually go in here that much. I actually use the function that I've set up in my camera target. You've got your camera settings here, perspective settings, or your target. The target's based on what you've clicked on and stuff. I mean, when you're in the actual camera setting itself, there is some shortcuts. So obviously right mouse, you can move about. I've got my middle mouse button set to zoom in and out, but you can also use control and alt. And like I said, I've gone right in now and I'm like, oh, I've got to zoom out, get it right. But again, just click reset, it will come back. So again, control and alt, while we're in this kind of camera view, you can use these settings as well. When you come into perspective view, again, you come into here, you've got your, I think it's, let me just remember how you do this. So alt, left mouse click is to rotate. I've got my middle mouse button, like I said, to zoom in and so on. And then if you hold shift and alt, that's going to let you just move it all around with your left mouse button as well. And then under target, that's literally the target of what option you're kind of on, what object you're on. Do you know what I mean? It'll jump to that object by clicking and stuff through there as well. Close, obviously close the window. You've got the different kind of options. Let me just reset that for the clay. All layers, so it's a background layer and there's your main layer. You've got your beauty pass. If you want to do different passes or load them in here, what you need to do is you need to come into your actual Octane Universal Material. When you come into it, and incidentally, if you don't know, if you hold shift and click on any of the objects, it will go to their kind of texture and stuff, and it'll bring up the node editor. What I want to do is I want to go to the render target, open that node editor. And then what I want to do is I want to go down to the actual render passes. And then under here, what you've got is the different render passes and so on, under the different information. So you've got your beauty render passes, your info passes, layers and so on. So if I was to say click, I want wireframe, it doesn't show up in here unless you go up where it was with beauty. Now it'll list it under the beauty. And again, that's based on you clicking on which one you want and stuff. And again, on any of these, let's see, I've not really had a look at what they kind of look like. So shadow pass, and they're all on here. And again, you can just come in and save them if you want, or you can set them up to when you render out, you can set them up so it'll render out that pass as well, and you've got the settings for it as well. And when you unclick it, obviously it will then remove them from here. But you can, again, it might help, I don't, some of them, depends how you've got it set up, it'll help you find where that noise is and maybe go and play around with the settings to find how to get rid of the noise and stuff and so on and so forth. But yeah, you have to go into the actual, again, you have to go into the render target, go into your render passes, and then come here to turn on which one, which one it is you want to kind of bring up in your, here with your beauty pass. The HDR L, is it I or ILS? So you've got, you need Light Studio Pro, I think it's called, or HDR Light Studio Pro, which I used to have years ago, but I don't have it anymore. If it works with this Octane and the new Lightwave, I don't know. I have heard there's a few bugs, and so if you've got this and it's working, this is where you'll use it. So it makes it, basically it makes it, you can use the HDR Light Studio interactively with the IPR window, but I haven't got it as well. So you've got the set, excuse me, you've got like the S, what's this one? So SH ball, I've never really used that. Far as I know, it's to enable a shader ball function. Half res, half res. So most people using Octane's got a decent-ish graphics card, but if not, and oh, you've got a busy scene, clicking half res makes it about four times slower. But I don't need it in this scene. You've got your alpha stats, tells you everything about the scene. Region, so region lets you choose the region, so you can move it where you want, or you can hold down control and choose a region as well. I use this quite a lot, so when I load up the IPR window, I put fixed ratio on, so when I'm moving the window about, if I want to make it bigger or smaller, it keeps that fixed ratio based on your camera and stuff, so that's quite handy to have. So that's something I usually click on as well when doing stuff and going through. And there's a few other little bits here that I've not actually used that much, to be fair. I mean, you've got your max upload, which is just similar to pause function, really. I mean, I've not really used it that much. So you've got no upload, which is similar to your pause. You've got your max upload, which supposedly enables an update to the render and the animated parameters and stuff, but I've not really used them. And again, sell only, that's something else I've not really used that much. But again, so I'm just showing you what I've kind of found out myself. And now and then, if I'm moving around a scene and I want different shots, I do use clone a lot. So when you click clone, it just clones the window and I can keep that, go somewhere else, find a different kind of shot or whatever I kind of want to do. And I've always got this shot on auto, have a look at if I want to check my light from different sides and stuff. But yeah, I've kind of zipped through that, just trying to say what I've learned about this and stuff. I'm slightly disappointed with the actual, I quite liked, you know, if I wanted to turn on, and I bet you can do it, I've just not learned it yet, your wireframe on top of the colours or the textures, or your silhouette colours, so you can work with all these actual settings. But as far as I know, I mean, please put it in your, in my actual comments, that with this, you can't have them on at the same time. So, you know, if you want wireframe over the top, you can save them out separately in Photoshop, post-production do it, but you can't put them on in here. So if I wanted to use, like, in like Lightwave, you can put, like, silhouette edges and stuff. But, again, I haven't looked into that, but as far as I know, I can't see how you do that directly in the IPR window. But if anyone knows different, which, again, there probably is, please let me know. But yeah, that's a very quick look at the IPR window without going too much in depth, just so you can understand some of these. And some of them I've not really used or understood myself, but most of them I do. That's why I've just explained it. And also I've used a docs online to have a look, the Octane docs, which is quite useful as well. So thanks for listening. Please share, subscribe, and check out my other videos. And go and check out Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. See you next time.